talk about the qualities of the auditor, right? So one of the questions which we now have over there is regarding the qualities of the auditor, right? So importance, benefits, definition, objective, scope, limitations, origin, relationship, we've studied. Now we need to talk about the qualities of an auditor. Right, so qualities of an auditor. Yes, please mute yourself. Okay, right. What do you think should be? Oh, my robot PDF is closed. Right. What do you think should be the qualities of an auditor? Right. What do you think? What qualities should be there in an auditor? You are a chartered accountant doing the audit of a company. What qualities should be there in this particular fellow? Hello, the auditor, what quality should he be having? Does he need any quality, or without having any quality, he can just happily say that I am chartered accountant, so allow me to do the audit, right? Or is it that some sort of qualities are required in the CA? Confidentiality, sound mind, oh my God, honesty, oh wow. Yes, honesty, integrity, independence, disciplined, alert. Okay. My God, you people, when you become auditors, you will be like rock star auditors, you know, like, my God, the most happening ones over there. Right. So as an auditor, obviously, you know, if I tell you about the qualities of the auditor, just as we say, you know, there are 9 gemstones, or there used to be 9 planets. Now they say that Pluto is not there or whatever. But yeah, similarly over here, let us talk about the 9 qualities of the auditor, right? What are the 9 qualities of the CA? One, if it's a gemstone, and if it's like a diamond or something, what does the diamond do? If you happen to look at a good quality diamond, right, with good cut clarity and all, what does it, if you happen to look at it, you see that it is carat. Okay, so you see shining, sparkle, exactly, glow, wonderful. So now, again, the CA, who is the auditor of the company, he should have a shine of the culture. And a shine of the culture. Okay, you know, CA, you know, the fact that you're mentioning that you are a CA, that itself will demand the respect. Have you noticed that? The moment you come to know that somebody is a chartered accountant, when they say that, that itself demands a respect. Right? So obviously that's the shine of the culture. Right, of the demand of the chartered accountancy profession. And obviously, along with this shine, what you need to also have is your integrity. Straightforward, honest and sincere. A person who is one in thought, word and action. Not that thinks one thing, says one thing and does another thing. No. What he thinks, that he says, and that is done. And so that is integrity, straightforward, honest, sincere, truthfulness, you know, in his dealing, fair dealing, right? Then obviously 100% an important responsibility on the auditor is to maintain the independence. You know, independence, that the judgment of a person is not subordinate to the wishes or directions of the another person. Right, then after this integrity, shine of culture and the independence, then they talk about certain personal qualities. Right, personal qualities, right? Then they talk about certain basic human qualities. Obviously, personal and human, you can take it to be same. But yeah, in human quality, it says very important factor in a human, in a human being has to be the trust factor. Hello, the trust factor. So it says even in the chartered accountant, you're giving him the information regarding the company, you're sharing your company hardships with him. So there has to be a trust factor over there. And then personal qualities. Do you see the wonderful list of the personal qualities that they have made over there? Right. So it says the personal quality, tact. And you should have a tact, you know, a knack of dealing with people. He should have caution. And be careful when he is doing his work. If he should be able to sense any danger, he should be firm. The client is telling, no, no, CA, instead of 40 lakh, we give you 80 lakh fee, you don't say anything. No. Good temper. Oh my God. And there should no steam be coming out of the head of the CA. And he should be having a cool mind and a warm heart. Nowadays, people have a coldest heart and the warmest mind. No, 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 no. See, you should have I'm not telling this. It's written over here. And a good temper. Then he should have the integrity. Discretion, that is judgment, decision making, knowledge of human behavior. Okay, is this fellow making a fool out of me or telling me the correct thing? Industry. And industrious, like very busy. You see, as they are always so busy in their own work. You think, oh my God, such other big creatures roaming around them. But that small, little, tiniest object over there, it will carry one cube of sugar in it and be busy in its own world. Right? So similarly, you carry the burden of your CA syllabus and be busy. Right? So industry has to be there, right? It's your stature, your commitment towards the profession, judgment. Right? So again, the discretion, caution, judgment, patience. And that is again a missing element of the current times. And clear-headedness. And there should be no brain fog. And nowadays, you know, you can't even have a clarity of your thoughts. Why? Because there's so many aliens which are attacking your brain. So you don't even have a clear perspective or even can't think for sit for 5 minutes and quietly think about something. Continuously monkey mind running here and there. So it says clear-headedness and reliability are some of the qualities. So these are not all the qualities, are some of the qualities which an auditor should have. In short, all those personal qualities that go into the making of a good business person contribute to the making of a good auditor. Right? So obviously you doing your audit practice, you practicing as a chartered accountant is your business only. So it says all the qualities of a good business person should also contribute to the making of a good auditor, right? So that is your personal quality. Then after your personal quality, what do they talk about is your human quality. What is human quality? A person who auditor holds a position of trust must have the basic human qualities. And apart from that, he should also have the professional training and the education. So now what I do in these qualities, after the personal qualities, human qualities, then I will mention the professional qualities, that, you know, he is a very, very genuine person, very hardworking, and also a lot of trust is there. But he doesn't know anything regarding these standards on auditing, doesn't know CARO, Company Auditor Report Order, doesn't know Companies Act 2013. Right? Then you say, oh my God, and what to do of all your good deeds? And no use at all. So technically also you need to be sharp. Right, so that it says the professional training and the education, right? Professional training and the education. In addition, he must have the shine of the culture for attaining the great height, and he must have the highest degree of integrity backed by the adequate independence, right? So have we discussed these qualities of the CA over here? What qualities of the CA? Personal qualities, human qualities, professional qualities, shine of the culture, and then also having the integrity and the independence. Then after that, three more qualities of the CA. Okay, he is concerned with the reporting on the financial matters of the business, right? So you should be having the knowledge that financial matters are subject to human fallibility, errors and frauds could be frequent, right? So one, he should be having a knowledge now of the financial matters. Right, so now he should be having the knowledge ke what all, you know, challenges or issues come up in the financial matters. Then for that, he needs to critically review the financial statements, and it is obviously useless for him to attempt that task unless his own knowledge is that of an expert. Right, so he says he needs to have the expert knowledge as he needs to critically review. So one quality of the CA is that he should have the ability to critically review the financial statements of the company. And obviously, to critically review the financial statements of the company, an exhaustive knowledge of accounting in all its branches. And because we are the experts in that field, is the sine qua non. What is sine qua non? It's the prerequisite, right, of the practice of auditing. And it's a prerequisite for the practice of the auditing. He must thoroughly know all the accounting principles and techniques. Right. So that's the last one over there. The exhaustive knowledge of the accounting. Right. The exhaustive knowledge of the accounting. Right. So did you get the qualities of the auditor? Our auditor is shining like a gemstone. Yes, because he has the 9 qualities, like a gemstone, 9 gemstones. He's the Navratna. Our auditor is also a Navratna auditor. Right? So what are the 9 gems in him? He has the shine of the culture, integrity, independence. Then he has the personal quality, professional qualities, and the human qualities. And then he also has an understanding of financial matters. He knows that he needs to critically review the financial statements, and for that he needs an exhaustive knowledge of the accounting. Right, clear to it.